In this tutorial, I will show you how to create simple but effective animations with PowerPoint that can be exported as a movie file for your use in your video projects. Okay, so let's take a quick look first at a couple of examples of animations that I did in PowerPoint. The first one you see here, let's play it. This shows the oiling of a wetland, and the oil here is floating on the water surface, and now it's soaking into the ground. The plants die, and the soil collapses. Okay, that's a very quick, simple example. Here's another one showing the concept of subsidence, and let's play it. And what this is going to show is a skyline, a city, as the soil that has accumulated compacts and consolidates, subsidence occurs. And then I wanted to relate that to sea level rise, and so I continued with showing what causes the increase in the ocean surface, and then I wrapped it up by showing how subsidence and sea level rise combine to equal the total submergence that an area experiences. So how did I create these in PowerPoint? Let's take the subsidence example to illustrate. Close these windows out, and let's open up my file that I created in PowerPoint. Okay, first I decided on the sequence of steps, and I created a basic diagram to begin the sequence. And in this case, I wanted to show a land platform that would sink over time in relation to the water level, the ocean level. And this is easily created with the shape function by selecting the rectangle shape here, and that's all I did in this case. And so I have a rectangle here representing the soil platform, the land platform, and another rectangle representing the ocean. I next created a city profile, again using the shape function to create buildings, the rectangles and triangles used to create the roofs. And it's important to group all the components of a feature that is going to be moving together so that they all move together in succeeding slides. And so you can see that all these different components in this grouping, they've all been grouped up here. If you look under Arrange, you see that they are grouped, and I can ungroup them if I want, but we want them grouped. Okay, so now when I move this in the succeeding slides, they're all going to go together. Now you can, I could have also drawn plants to create a wetland here that would be sitting on this platform instead of a cityscape, but here I wanted to use a sinking city like New Orleans to illustrate the idea of subsidence. Okay, now all you have to do is to duplicate this slide. And if you select the slide over here in your slide navigator and go to Edit and select Duplicate, that slide is duplicated. And now what you can do is you can change something on this slide to move the movie forward. And we take that out because I've already duplicated it here and then here. And what I've done in this slide is I've added another component. And here I've added a component that gives a microscopic view of soil particles. And again, this is just a box, and it contains some drawings of soil particles that I created with the line and connector option here. I just used the scribble and drew a particle, and I filled it with a brown fill, and you can move it in there and resize it. You can rotate these so that they all don't look exactly the same. You can reverse them. You can do various things with it. So that's how I created this. And then again, I grouped all of those so that they all move together. And here they are, ungrouped and grouped. Okay, so that's a key point to keep in mind. Then what I wanted to do was I wanted to show what happens when the particles are squeezed together. And what I did then was to squash the box. And to do that, all you do is grab one of these points and pull the box down so that it is smaller in the vertical direction. And so that's all I did to create this next slide. And as I'm doing adding these elements, I've started adding text, as you see here, and arrows. Just a very simple explanation of what is going on. As water and gas are squeezed out of the spaces between soil particles, the soft sediments compact. And I add extra slides in here so that I have enough time if I want to add voiceover and explain or read what is written in the text. Okay, now the next one, you can see what I've done here is I removed the microscopic view of the soil particles, and now I'm beginning to animate the movement of the soil surface. And again, all I did was I moved the soil surface by squeezing the box from that position to this position. And so when you go from this slide to this slide, it appears that the soil surface is sinking. And I do it again in the next slide and squeeze the box even lower, and I continue doing that. And as you scroll through these, you can see it looks like the soil surface is decreasing. And again, it's important to duplicate each previous slide so everything is precisely the same. It's in the precisely the same position except for the element that you want to be changing. So next I move to explaining sea level rise and what causes it. And so I added another bit of text here, and then in the next slide I introduced a photograph showing an ice scape and added some text explaining that as global temperatures rise and land-based ice melts, oceans expand. And if we scroll through that, we then see what's happening. I am raising the height of the ocean surface, and it keeps getting higher and higher. And then I explain that this is called eustatic sea level rise. And then in the final slides, I wanted to explain the concept of relative sea level rise. So for that, what I did was I simply added a dashed line showing where the ocean surface was initially, and then had an arrow, put in an arrow pointing to where it ended up. And so this shows the distance over which the ocean height has changed. And then in the following slide, I put another dashed line showing where the landform was initially and where it ended up, and all combined, this equals the total submergence that this cityscape is experiencing. So now we've got a complete sequence of slides, starting from the beginning, and we scroll through them, and you begin to see how the movie is going to come out. Okay, I'm going to stop there, and I will continue the tutorial in part 2.